In this video, we're looking at a particularly challenging projectile motion problem. So the setup for the problem is that we have one person throwing a baseball with a known initial speed of 30 meters per second, and they're trying to achieve the perfect throw where this ball lands 25 meters away exactly at their friend's hands, which are at the same height as the release of the ball. Now the problem is to find the launch angle that's required for this baseball. And finding the launch angle is always the hardest class of projectile motion problem, because once you do the vertical and horizontal analysis of this flight, you're going to end up with two equations and two unknowns, and you have to find a way to use substitution to solve that system for the launch angle theta. But we're still going to start by expressing the components of the launch velocity. And so our horizontal component here is going to be 30 times the cosine of this unknown launch angle theta, while our vertical component is 30 times the sine of the launch angle theta. And one simplifying feature of this problem is that we actually have a completely level projectile motion problem. We're told these two people have exactly the same height, so our starting and finishing y coordinates are going to be the same for the flight. And we can just stick our origin for the problem at the point of the release of this baseball. So there's a little origin in the picture, and our x and y coordinates are going to be 0 there. And my final y coordinate is also 0 because the height of the person who catches the ball is exactly the same as the height of the person who threw it. So we get into trying to find this launch angle. And what I have to do here is somehow analyze what's going on in the vertical direction and the horizontal direction. So we'll see what comes out of that analysis and then hope we can put it together mathematically to figure out this launch angle. So I'm going to start with the vertical analysis of the problem. So that's y equals y naught plus v naught yt. And then plugging in negative g for the acceleration, I have minus 1/2 gt squared. So the initial and final y coordinates, we're calling those 0 because we put our origin at that height. And I have 0 is equal to 30 times the sine of theta times t minus 1/2 g times t squared. So it's important to note that this equation has two unknowns in it. There's the flight time and the launch angle. But we can solve for the flight time here in terms of the launch angle. And there's two different solutions to this. I can see that t equals 0 is one solution. And the reason that pops out is because the height is 0 at t equals 0. It's just that we're not interested in that moment in time. It's the other one we're interested in. So we're going to cancel out one factor of t. And this leaves us a linear equation in t, and we're going to go ahead and add 1/2 gt to both sides and then multiply by 2 and divide by g to isolate the flight time. So this gives us a time of 60 sine theta, again, that's still an unknown, divided by g. All right, now we look at the horizontal analysis of the problem. So we have x equals x naught plus v naught x t. There is no acceleration in the horizontal direction for a projectile. In our initial x coordinate, we called that 0. We put the origin at that location. Our final x coordinate, well, we were given that information. We know the range of this flight is 25 meters. So we plug in our initial x velocity of 30 cosine theta. And again, we're looking at an equation with two unknowns in it, where those are the launch angle and the time for the flight. So now the point is to put these two equations together by making this substitution for the time. T is 60 sine theta over g, so I can replace it with that in my x equation. So I have 25 is equal to 30 cosine theta times t, which is 60 sine theta over g. And now I'm going to use a common trick that we've seen before, and I'll post a link at the top to an example where this same trick recently happened. But what I'm going to do here is collect the sine and the cosine, and I'm going to use the identity that 2 times sine times cosine gives me the sine of twice the angle. So I'm going to split off a factor of 2, just say from the 60 here, and turn it into a 30. And I'll go ahead and just throw in the 9.8 for g at this point. So again, 2 times the cosine of theta times the sine of theta, that's the sine of 2 theta. So I'm going to isolate that on the right-hand side. So we multiply by 9.8, so I have 25 times 9.8. divided by 30 squared, and that's going to be equal to the sine of 2 theta. And the whole point here is now that that's written as a single trig function, I can invert it. And we'll just do all this in our calculator. We take 25 times 9.8 divided by the square of 30, and then take the inverse sine of that number. And what that gives us is an answer for twice the angle. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 15.8 degrees. And this means the launch angle required to go 25 meters with a launch velocity of 30 meters per second turns out to be 7.90 degrees if we keep our traditional three significant digits. All right, so that was the hard part. And then in part B, we're asked a little follow-up question where we want to get the maximum height of the baseball relative to the height you released it from your hand. In other words, relative to the origin that we already decided on. So maximum height, there's this key physical point about it that at the maximum height, we have a y velocity of zero. Then what we can do is use the time-independent kinematics equation. Vy squared is v naught y squared plus 2a times y minus y naught, where that a is the y acceleration for the object. So our final y velocity is going to be zero. Our initial y value is going to be zero. And so we end up with zero on the left-hand side is equal to v naught y squared. Well, now that we know the launch angle, we can actually compute v naught y explicitly. That's going to be 30 times the sine of 7.9 degrees. And we're going to square that. And then we'll throw in negative 9.8 for our y acceleration. And the only unknown there is the final y value for the process. And this can be done all at once in a calculator. We just take 30 sine 7.9 and square it. Then we'll subtract that from both sides and divide by negative 2 times 9.8. And when I do this, I get an answer of y equals 0.867 meters for the maximum height. So I think this turned out to be a pretty realistic baseball throw. We have a launch angle of only about 8 degrees, and it's a pretty flat throw. So it doesn't even rise more than a meter over the position you launched it, even at its highest point on the trajectory. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.